In the first example in lesson 3, we're evaluating x squared y minus y when x equals negative 2 and y equals negative 4. We simply need to replace our x's and y's with their numbers. So first, x squared, x is negative 2, so I'll put in negative 2, square that. And then my y is negative 4, so I put negative 4 in place of y. Okay, and then I can go ahead and start using the order of operations to solve my problem. So I want to use this exponent here first, so negative 2 squared is 4. And then two negatives will make a positive. 4 times a negative 4 is negative 16 plus 4. That is a negative 12. And then we've evaluated the expression. In the second example in lesson 3, we're again evaluating an expression. This time a equals negative 2 and b equals 4. So we will replace the a with negative 2 and the b with 4. So there's a negative 2 times a negative and 4 for the b minus negative 2, close our parentheses, minus negative 2 times 4. Okay, and then again we just use the order of operations. So I'll have a negative 4 plus 2. And then I can go ahead and multiply these together. So negative 2 times 4 is a negative 8. Right, and simplify inside the parenthesis here. So negative 4 plus 2 is a negative 2. Still being multiplied by the negative 2 that was already there. And then two negatives will make a positive. So plus 8. Negative 2 times negative 2 is 4. Plus 8. And then 4 plus 8 is 12. And we've evaluated our expression. In the third example in lesson 3, we're simplifying by adding like terms. So what we need to do is find out which terms are like terms. So I will highlight all the xy's. It's okay if the coefficient is not the same, but the x and y need to be in there, and they also need to have the same exponents. So that is all of our xy terms. Okay, and then I'll see if there are any other x terms, and there is. There's the negative 2x and the 3x. And then I have this 4, which doesn't have a like term, so that one will just stay the same. So I'm going to have 3xy plus a negative 6, and that's yx, but really that is the same as an xy. So that will give me a negative 3xy. Okay, so I work through those. Okay, then I'm going to combine my x's. I'll have a negative 2x plus 3x, and that will give me a positive 1x. And then the plus 4 just stayed the same. So my final answer would be negative 3xy plus just an x, because that's the same as a 1x, plus 4. And we have simplified by adding like terms. In the fourth example of lesson 3, we're again simplifying by adding like terms, but this time they're not in all the same format. So what we need to do is change the format so they all will be the same. I'm just going to move all the variables up into the numerator, top of the fraction line, so that I can easily look and see whether they have the same variables and the same exponents. So on my first one here, I have 3a to the negative 2b, and then c is going to move up, so it's going to change the sign of its exponent, so it's going to be c to the negative 1 power. So for my next one, I'm going to keep the minus sign the same. I'm going to have 4, move the a up, so it'll be a to the negative 2 power. B will stay the same, and C will have a negative 1 power. Okay, the plus sign, again, will stay the same. And the 7, a negative 2 power. And I'm going to change the order so they're all in the same order. So the B and then C to the negative 1 power. And then minus 4. Okay, the A squared will stay on top. The B stays on top and the C comes to the top, so it's C to the negative 1. Okay, so now we're going to identify which ones are like terms. So which ones have the A to the negative 2, B to the positive 1, and C to the negative 1? I can see that the negative 4 does. The 7 does, but on the last one, the power of A is positive and not negative, so that will not be a like term. Okay, so I will combine all of my like terms, so I'll have 3 minus 4. Plus 7, and then the a to the negative 2, b and c to the negative 1 will stay the same. This negative 4, a squared, b, c to the negative 1 will stay the same. So when I add these together, I have 3 minus 4, that's a negative 1, plus 7 is 6. So that'll be 6a. Negative 2 power b c to the negative 1 minus 4 a squared b c to the negative 1 power. And we have simplified by adding like terms.